AAU in July is the biggest college recruiting period of the year. There are hundreds, even thousands of college coaches in the gym. A group of Australian high schoolers have come together to showcase their skills against some of the best competition in the United States. They don't have big names, it's easy to write them off, but they all have the dream to play college basketball. This is their story.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we prepare for our final descent, please make sure your seatbelts are securely fastened.
I'm really excited for the guys to experience everything that Lalimer has to offer, you know, between the fields, the lakes, just the beautiful campus itself. Our guys will be able to stay in the dorms just as normal Lalimer students would be. They have full access to the student center, library, rec center, and the cafeteria. At Lalimer, we've been a national basketball powerhouse the last 5 years. We've played on ESPN the last 3 years in the national tournament. We're excited to have the guys on campus and for them to experience what life as a Lalimer student might be like too. This training camp will be like nothing we have experienced. Two-a-days, sand dune workouts, and team practices will challenge us mentally and physically. For the next 21 days, we are a team with one goal. It is our chance to be seen by college coaches and earn our spot. My personal goal for the training camp is for the players to be able to feel the intensity of what the games will be like. The intensity of training camp will probably be something they've never experienced before. One of the key components of our tour is giving the players a chance to experience American college campuses and their basketball facilities.
It's the biggest university stadium I've ever been in. It's pretty crazy. The campus, the stadium, the football stadiums are massive.
Definitely very crazy. It's so big. It's nothing like Australia.
The University of Notre Dame is one of the most prestigious colleges in the country. They have the highest level of basketball and football, along with great academics. We also find a way to show the players the unique type of workouts that college programs use with their own players. These dunes are as much of a mental challenge as they are a physical challenge. Our players have to be able to separate themselves from the pack with their will to work. Running these sand dunes helps them realize just how hard they can work and they need to. After doing these hills, everything on the court is easy.
Sand dunes was probably one of the hardest things I've ever done.
Hardest thing mentally and physically, especially for my legs.
You know, I'm used to the sand dunes back in Australia, and they're probably half that size.
We've had a great start to the tour with plenty of intense workouts. It's time we take a day off of our legs and enjoy the 4th of July, a big American holiday. We'll be right back. How's it feel, H?
Freezing.
Feels good though.
I feel much better after.
We've been doing double day sessions for the last couple of days. Been pretty tough, you know. This morning session is probably the hardest one we've done so far. Got to try and stay 100%, so recovery is very important, and ice bath is probably the best thing to do right now.
It's been a good week of training camp. All the boys have been out here working really hard. I'm just out here getting a few extra shots in. Tournaments start tomorrow. Going to get exposed to so many college coaches, so many colleges. Can't wait to get started.
The Elite Academic Showcase is one of the premier showcases in America. Hundreds of high academic universities will come and evaluate our players. Our guys are going to have a chance to go against some of the best players in the country while showcasing their skills.
My name is Levon Thomas. I'm 15 years old. I'm playing with the Australian team at the Elite Showcase.
Serge, what did you think of that first game?
That was one of the fastest games I've ever experienced, played against. Like, the talent here is just absolutely amazing, and you know, the boys fought hard and just played absolutely brilliant. I'm lucky we didn't get the win, but you know, that's what happens in basketball. One, two, three, be great!
The entire gym rushed over to our court to watch Nick Pozoglou and Devon Dillard go at it. It was one of the most electrifying events of the summer.
So the boys did pretty well today. Unfortunately, we lost two games. Third game was great. We got the win. Nick Poz stepped up. You know, he threw one down, big one. Probably going to be on ball his life. Overall, it was a good day, but proud of the guys, and hopefully we carry it over to the following tournaments.
You know, we've been lucky. We always have kids from around the Midwest, different parts of the country, Florida and California, come here. So for us this year to have kids from a different country, really unique and really special. And their kids are great. They brought great energy. They represent themselves well. Not only as good basketball players, but just the energy of how they carry themselves. They showed really well for their country, and they did great in the camp. Really good kids.
Lalemeer is just a short drive from one of the most beautiful cities in the world. Chicago in the summertime is an amazing thing. The Chicago Hoops Tournament is the premier event in Chicago of the entire summer. Over 500 college coaches will be in attendance evaluating players. Our guys are going to have to prove who people are. Some of the top nationally ranked players in the entire country will be here competing against one another.
Good job, Sukhman. Nice tip, Serge. Good, Serge.
The first game of the tournament resulted in us defeating the Illinois Gold Rush 72-65. Our second game of pool play was against the Speech Gym Rats from Fort Wayne, Indiana.
Just understand, this game is far from over.
Great effort by the boys from Shire. We came out with a different mindset today. We attacked the ring ball, and yeah, if it wasn't for Coach Brad, give us that motivation. We were down 18, and then we brought it back one by 2 points. Personally, you know, man, I've never played in this type of competition before, so the first, you know, 3-4 games, I was a bit nervous, wasn't confident with the ball. Woke up this morning with a different mindset. Every time I got the ball, I looked to attack the rim, and yeah, the game just came to me.
By finishing in the top two of our pool, we advanced to the tournament knockout stage. We were matched up against a very well-coached Illinois Old School team, a program that year in and year out produces Division I players. Our guys battled throughout, but came up just short. The Chicago Hoops Tournament was a great experience for our guys. It showed where we stack up against the best players and teams in the entire country. It's time to rest our legs for a few days and head to the biggest tournament of the summer, Summer Jam. The NY2LA Summer Jam is the biggest tournament in the United States every summer. Last year, over 1,300 different college coaches attended the tournament.
Summer Jam tips off tonight. First game's at 6 o'clock, so keen to get things underway. Been preparing for 2 days, got fresh legs, so it should be good.
Our first game of the tournament was against the Wisconsin Playground Warriors, a nationally renowned program. This year, they feature Brevin Pritzel, a University of Wisconsin commit. Thank you. We fought off early nerves, and once we settled in, we gave the Playground Warriors all they could handle, but fell just short. The gym was buzzing with the style of play, intensity, and togetherness that the AUSA Hoops team displayed.
We win this game, play in front of more coaches, so it's just more important, I reckon. Preparation's key.
Our second game of the tournament was against Next Level from Louisville, Kentucky. This was the best game the AUSA Hoops team played all summer. It seemed like a dream, but Mike Krzyzewski and Steve Alford sat courtside for our entire game. We won by a mercy rule and opened the eyes of hundreds of college coaches. After a team and some individual standout performances, scholarships began to come in. The dream is becoming real. Our third game of Super Pool play was against the Central Illinois Net Game, a team that ended in the Elite Eight of the Platinum Bracket of the tournament. Our guys played an unbelievable first half of basketball. As the game wore on, Net Game's depth proved to be too much. We ended up falling by 10 points. Finishing 1-2 in Super Pool play, it's win or go home in the knockout stage. And our guys know against the Milwaukee Rebels, this could be the last game of AAU basketball. Here we will face one of the most electrifying guards in the country, Trey Jefferson. After securing an early lead, the Milwaukee Rebels rallied and created a big lead of their own. Our guys came out clicking on all cylinders. Tough play down the stretch cut a 16-point deficit to a two-possession game with a minute left. But the big lead was just too much to overcome. The AUSA Hoops team ended up falling by 8, concluding the tournament at 1-3. For the AUSA Hoops team, the July AAU season was a huge success. We had the opportunity to play against some of the best players in the country. Coaches from all levels were able to watch, evaluate, and are now recruiting our players. This tour was an amazing experience for not only the players, but myself. The ability to work with and hopefully fulfill dreams was one of the best things I've ever been involved in. My hometown has cursed me lately. Run.